Good morning, friends. Coach Campbell here. So happy to see you again. It is April 2nd, 2020, and let's get started. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. God, let me play well but fairly. Let competition make me strong but never hostile. Forbid me to rejoice in the adversity of others. See me not when I am cheered, but when I bend down to help my opponent up. If I know victory, allow me to be happy. If I am denied, keep me from envy. Remind me that sports are just games. Help me to learn something that matters once the game is over. And if through athletics I set an example, let it be a good one. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, friends. So today we are talking about jogging and running. Before we get started, let's talk about safety. Make sure that you check with your parents before you do any of the activities that I suggest. And so Khaleesi, my student, Khaleesi, is the one that suggested we talk about jogging and running. And so let's talk about our essential question. How can I be the healthiest person mentally, spiritually, emotionally, and physically? So mentally, crazy enough, I am a runner, was a runner. And there's a lot of games I think that runners play in their head, working on saying foreign languages or doing math equations, things to make the time go by and to distract themselves. So that's a wonderful thing about running mentally, emotionally. People feel better after they run. Running releases endorphins and it makes you feel better. Spiritually, running is a great time for prayer. The students and I at the school have started saying a walking rosary, and that came from me saying a running rosary. Running is a great time to pray, and physically, obviously, running is fantastic cardiovascular activity. And thank you, Khaleesi. I never knew the difference between running and jogging. I didn't know that there was a difference. I just thought it was an effort thing. But lo and behold, running is when you are going faster than 6 miles per hour. And if both feet are off the ground at the same time, and you're going slower than 6 miles an hour, that's considered jogging. Who knew? Not me, maybe you. And if you didn't, then we learned something new today. So I love you guys. I'm proud of you. If it's okay with your mom and dad, go out for a jog. See if it makes your body feel better. Take care of yourself. Be kind to yourself. Be kind to those around you. I love you so much. I'm proud of you for doing the best that you can do. Keep up the good work, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.